Okay, hello everyone, how are you doing? So in this video, I will discuss about AC to DC rectifier, single phase full wave control rectifier, bridge rectifier types. The load is just a resistor only. So we have a resistor load. Okay, control rectifier means that we will use thyristor. Okay, thyristor. Okay, we know that to switch on the thyristor, we need Vs greater than 0 and I get not equal to 0. So we need to firing I get into gate terminal. I get. So I get. Yes, to supply I get to gate terminal. So to switch on the thyristor. Okay. Okay, in this rectifier, bridge rectifier, here is input side, so AC source. Okay, so from AC source, it will convert to DC signal here at output, DC output. Okay, in this case, we use power setting, DC output, power setting, full wave. Now, first we analyze all the waveform or the related waveform, the component of thyristor, voltage, current, input waveform, voltage waveform, current waveform, voltage at thyristor and current at all the thyristor. Okay, we will analyze all the parameters related in the AC, in this AC to DC rectifier. Okay, bridge. In order to analyze the waveform, we will divide into a few sections. So based on the input cycle, we have input signal is sine wave, Vm sine omega t, okay, sine wave. So we have positive cycle and negative cycle. Okay, two wave, positive and negative. Then it will repeat positive, negative, positive, negative. So we just focus on this one period only. Then we will split into a few sections. First section is from 0 to alpha. First section. Second section is from alpha to pi. Second section. Third section is from pi to this we call alpha to. And then fourth section from alpha to 2 pi. So we will analyze all the waveform, gate current waveform, output voltage waveform, output current waveform, voltage at thyristor 1 and thyristor 2 waveform, and also voltage at thyristor 3 and thyristor 4 waveform. Now we start at first section. Okay, this section, our input, this part input. Okay, this section is from 0 to alpha. Okay, first I need to erase. First section from 0 to alpha. Okay, the input is positive. So this is our input. Positive cycle. So from 0 to alpha is here. Okay. Okay, the positive cycle, our input positive. Waveform like this. Okay, plus, minus. So during at first stage, from 0 to alpha, you can refer to gate current, IG, is 0. Okay, IG equal to 0. Okay, when IG equal to 0 means that the thyristor is not triggered yet. So that means T1, T2, T3, T4, off. off. So T1 off, T3 off, T4 off, T2 also off. So current here, and current go here and here to this point. So this off, T1 off, T4 also off. So that means IS equal to 0. Current cannot flow. Okay, I out is here. I out also equal to 0. V out equal to I times R equal to 0 volt. Okay, I 0. So V output voltage will be 0. Okay, waveform. Let check the waveform. V out 0. Okay, 0. I out also 0. Okay, VT1 and VT2. Where is T1? T1 is here. So positive, negative, positive, negative. Okay, look here. This is positive, negative, positive, negative. So just follow polarity. Okay. Okay, this is our VS. This point and this point. So positive, negative. Okay, this one is negative, not positive. So same point. Positive, negative. Okay, VS. Polarity of VS. So we can see how well is T1. T1 compared to TS. Let's say this is VS. VT1 same, so plus and plus, so same plus and plus means that VT1 equal to VS. Okay, how about VT3? Okay, VT3 is plus here minus VS. You can see here minus VS. Okay, plus minus VT3. Okay, we can see that VT3 is equal to minus VS, VT1 equal to VS, VT3 equal to minus VS. And how about T2? Okay, so it's plus as minus, it's also minus. Okay, if we plot minus VS, VT2. So it means that VT2 equal to VS, then VT4, polarity plus minus VT4. About VS. Okay, from this one we can say that VT4 equal to minus VS. Alright, so VS is like this, positive waveform. So VT1 equal to VS from 0 to alpha. So from 0 to alpha, VT1 same as VS, okay, positive waveform. And also VT2, as VT2, okay, VT2 and VT1, VT3 and VT4 minus VS. Okay, from 0 to alpha, okay, minus VS. VS is positive waveform, so minus. You just minus waveform. Okay, from 0 to alpha, VT3 and VT4. Okay, that one is during first section from 0 to alpha. Okay, next section is from alpha to pi section. Okay. And to erase first. Second section from alpha to pi. Okay, from alpha to pi. Look at this. Look at gate current. So from alpha to alpha, T1 and T2 supply current to T1 and T2. So T1 give gate current and T2. So what happened to this thyristor? This thyristor will be T1 and T2 forward conducting mode will be on. T3 and T4 reverse blocking mode off. Okay, T1 will be on, T2 will be on, short circuit. Okay, on short circuit, on short circuit. Okay, the input is positive cycle. This. Okay, arrow will be like this, plus minus. Then current will flow from plus terminal, this direction, go here until here, and then go pass through T1, thyristor 1, go to the load, go to R, pass T2, go back to source. Okay, VS. Complete one cycle. Okay, when thyristor turn on, thyristor 2 and thyristor turn on at alpha. Okay, start from alpha, we switch on the thyristor. So current can flow. So this one is IR. So V out will be equal to IR times R. So we're doing KVL here. KVL at positive terminal. KVL, we will get V out equal to Vs minus VT1 minus VT2. Okay. VT1 is 0, 0, because T1 and T2 is short circuit. Switch on the short circuit. So V0 will be equal to Vs equal to Vm sine omega t. Okay, from alpha to pi, they will follow the input, same as the input. Okay, from alpha to pi, V0 equal to Vm sine omega t, exactly same as the input from alpha to pi. Okay, how about the current? Current equal to V over R. So this voltage divided by this resistor. V over R. So waveform will be same as voltage waveform. Okay, sorry, this is our VR. VR same as Vin. Okay, VR same as Vin. Vin like this. We out also will be same. Okay, before that, during first section, this one is negative. So, will be complete. I0, same as voltage waveform. Okay, follow voltage waveform from alpha to pi. Okay, next is thyristor 1 and thyristor 2. Okay, thyristor 1 and thyristor 2 is short circuit. So for short circuit means that 0 volt. Thyristor 2 also 0 volt short circuit. So from alpha to pi, فرشتة 2 انترس كمان اشياء سكي 0 فولت. Then is T3 and T4. Okay, T3 and T4. This is negative terminal. This is positive terminal. Positive terminal, negative terminal. Okay. We can use KVL. For that, I just want to erase. Okay. Now I want to change to green color. We do KVL here. KVL. KVL this loop. Okay, minus. Sorry, plus. Also plus. Okay, KVL plus VT3 plus VOUT equal to 0. So VT3 equal to minus VOUT. Then is another one is KVL at this loop. We can use KVL. Okay, plus VT plus VOUT plus VT4 plus VOUT equal to 0, VT4 equal to minus VOUT. Okay. VT3 equal to VT4 equal to minus VOUT. So start from alpha to pi. Okay. So that's mean inverse of VOUT. Inverse of VOUT waveform. Okay, you can see VOUT waveform like this. So the output will be inverse, negative VOUT. Okay. This waveform. Negative VOUT. Waveform for our VOUT is positive. VOUT. So the inverse means that negative. Okay. From pi, from alpha to pi. Or previously, like this. Now complete one cycle. Okay, the one is during alpha to pi. Okay, next is third section is from pi to alpha. Okay, let me erase first. Third section from pi to alpha. Okay, from pi to alpha, the range section. Okay, negative waveform, negative cycle. The input is negative cycle, and then the IG, so gate, there's no IG. IG equal to 0 means that T1, T2, T3, T4 off. Okay, there's no current. Also no current. So T1, T2, all the thyristor will be off condition. So this one is during negative cycle. So it will be like this, plus minus. So we can see that when this off, so I naught will be equal to 0, V naught also equal to 0. Okay, during alpha, pi to alpha, okay, 0, V naught 0, I naught also 0. Okay, now let's analyze the waveform of V thyristor 1, thyristor 2, thyristor 3, and thyristor 4. Okay, we know that thyristor 1 is here, plus, minus. Okay, just follow the arrow, plus, minus. Okay, VT1, VT3, plus, minus, plus minus plus minus. Okay. Okay, Vs like this minus. Okay, just connect plus. Okay, plus here. Minus here. So polarity of Vs will be like this. Vs. Okay. Now we want to check about the relation between T1 and Vs. Okay, arrow T1 and Vs, look here. They share plus and minus. T1 plus, Ts is minus. Vs. Okay. So, from this equation, we can say that then when we do KVL, VT1 equal to VS. Okay. Good. Next is relation between Vs and T3. Okay, they share positive terminal here. So Vs VT3. So means that VT3 equal to minus Vs. Okay. Next is Vs and T2. Okay. Look here. VT2 equal to Vs. Then how about this one? VT4. We can say that VT4 equal to minus Vs. Okay. So where VT1? VT1 here and VT2 here. VT1 equal to Vs, VT2 also equal to Vs. Okay. Same graph from alpha. Sorry, from pi to alpha, VT1 equal to Vs. Okay, Vs negative waveform like this. So VT1 and VT2 same exactly as Vs. And about VT3 and VT4, VT3 and VT4 negative. Negative means that VT3 and VT4 inverse of Vs. So Vs is negative, so VT4 will be positive from pi to alpha, positive. Okay, that one is during third section, from pi to alpha, third section. Okay, now we go to fourth section, from alpha to 2 pi, fourth section, alpha to 2 pi. Let me erase first. Okay, fourth section is from alpha to 2 pi. Okay, this section number 4. Output will be, input will be negative cycle. So from alpha to pi, we look at gate current. Gate current is provide to T1 and T4. I get equal to not equal to 0 for T3 and T4. So means that T3 and T4 will be switched on. 41 and T2 off. There's no gate current. Gate current is just for T3 and T4. Okay, T3 and T4 will be short circuit. Short circuit. Okay, this one is a negative cycle. Negative cycle. So repeat like this. So current will flow from positive terminal, go to this area, and then go to pass to thyristor number 3, and then go pass to our load, go back to T4, and go back to V source. Complete one cycle. This one is curve. So we have I naught. So the one is V out equal to I times R. Okay, we do KVL. KVL at this KVL here. This one is plus. This one also plus. So KVL plus VS plus V naught equal to 0. So V naught equal to minus VS. Means that V naught is inverse of the VS. Okay, in this case, our VS negative, so V naught will be positive. Perform. For negative input, VS is negative. V naught will be inverse of the VS, so positive. So it's negative, so inverse will become positive. How about I naught? I naught equal to V naught over R. Okay, we know that I naught will always follow waveform of V out. So V out positive, I naught also positive. From alpha to 2 pi. Alpha 2 pi. Okay, next is voltage at thyristor number 1 and voltage at thyristor number 4. We know that thyristor 3 is short circuit. Thyristor 4 also short circuit. So for short circuit, 0 volt, 0 volt. So during alpha to 2 pi, both of thyristor short circuit. So both of thyristor 0 volt. Then is VT1 and VT2. VT1 is here. VT2 is here. So let me erase first. Okay. Change color. So we do KVL. KVL this loop. So plus, minus. Yeah, so it's plus, minus. So plus, minus. Just follow plus, minus. Okay, KVL. We take plus VT2. Plus VR. Equal to 0. So VT2 equal to minus V out. Next is we do KVL at T1. So KVL here. Okay, plus VT1. Plus VR go to 0, VT1 go to minus V out. Okay, we can say that VT1 and VT2, the output waveform or the waveform at VT1 and VT2 is minus V out. So inverse of the waveform V out waveform. So we in this case our output V out is positive. So inverse negative. negative waveform from alpha to pi. Okay, so I not with T1, T2. Okay, now I finish sketching the waveform of each component. Thyristor 1, thyristor 2, thyristor 3, thyristor 4, and also V out waveform, and so I out waveform. So now we go to derivation of equation. So we have V out and I out. Okay, our output will be I out DC. So this is DC output. So I out, V out, average, and RMS. Okay. So we derive after this. So we need to erase. Okay. This one is input AC. So output DC. So output is I out and also V out. So first we derive derivation V out. That's we derive average. Output average equal to area divided by time period. Okay, this is our V out. We have form like this. So area is this area from alpha to pi. T is we take pi. Okay, pi. So equal 1 over pi 1 over t from alpha to pi. Vm, okay, Vm, our input is Vm sine omega t d omega t equal to Vm over pi alpha pi sine omega t d omega t. Okay, next Vm over pi will be equal to minus cos cos omega t from pi to alpha. So we take out minus here. Pi minus cos alpha. Cos is minus 1, minus cos alpha. So will be equal to Vm over pi 1 plus cos alpha. Okay, that is V out average. Next is I out average go to V out average divided by R. Okay. This is our R. So V out I go to V out over R. So V out average over R. I out one plus cos alpha. Okay, that one is our average. So next is RMS. Okay, we know that VRMS is V root mean square equal to root mean is average square, so equal to okay, take this value. One over pi from alpha to pi. Okay, Vm sine omega t k square d omega t. So what we have is 1 over pi Vm square sine omega t d omega t. Okay, root. Wow. So we can take out Vm square. Alpha to pi, alpha pi sine omega t d omega t. So now we can change sine to identity. So first we take out Vm over pi. Alpha sine square equal to 1. Minus cos 2 omega t over 2 d omega t. Okay, take out 2. One minus cos d omega t. D omega t cos 2 omega t d omega t. Vm over square root 2 pi root omega t pi alpha minus sine 2 omega t over 2 pi alpha. Two pi pi minus alpha minus 1 over 2 sine 2 pi minus sine 2 alpha. So this will come 0. So finally we'll have Vm over 2 pi minus alpha minus sine 2 alpha over 2. Okay, this one is VRMS. IRMS equal to VRMS divided by R. Okay, this is last one. So this okay, this is our VRMS, IRMS, I average, V out average, oops, I think I have a mistake, okay, VRMS, correction. So we have minus here, and also minus here. So minus and minus will become plus. Okay. Sorry for the mistake. Okay, I think that's all. That's all for our AC to DC rectifier. Based on bridge rectifier, and load is just a resistor only. That's all. Thank you. Bye bye. Stay safe, everyone.